Hello, my beautiful souls. How is everyone doing today? It is Dena from Miladyleela.com. And today I am coming to you from my wardrobe. Here again, I am sitting on my tiny little love seat in the corner of my wardrobe, surrounded by two of my clothing racks. And behind me is a gorgeous, literally antique picture of my grandparents on their wedding. So I love this spot and this area in my wardrobe. So welcome to my wardrobe. Thank you for being here. If you are new, I am so glad that you are here. If you have been following me for a while, welcome back. And I'd like to invite you to subscribe to my channel if you have not yet done so already. I would appreciate that. I'm trying to grow this channel. We have all kinds of cool things happening here on this channel. It's an eclectic mix of fashion, creative things, spiritual things. It's just really, really a fun place to be with like-minded souls. So please do subscribe and join the tribe. Yes, and hit that bell. Right? Okay, so the video today, we are going to be talking about ephemera. This isn't necessarily your typical ephemera, but yet it could be. I don't know. Basically, what I'm going to share with you today is some items that I found. These are treasures, personal treasures that I found while transitioning into the storybook cottage. Those of you that have been with me for a while know that we have been transitioning to this beautiful cottage for quite a while, and I don't know how much longer it's going to be before I continue to say how or why, other than the fact that I think I'm going to have to film a video so that I can reference to that video of the storybook cottage and what it's about, why we named it that. But before I do that video, I should probably tell you here that we inherited my mother-in-law's home, and she just recently passed, and I miss her so, so much, you guys. Oh my God. I see her every day. I feel her every day, and I'm reminded of her every day. She left me some really beautiful treasures, including this gorgeous home. And we have moved from our beloved castle here to the cottage. And my daughter and her family is now staying at the castle. And they really needed the room. And Jimmy and I really needed to downsize. Yes. So we are here in this beautiful, quaint, cozy little cottage that I was able to create this gorgeous space. And I cannot wait to share it with you. That is going to be a video coming. I have a home tour coming for those of you that are interested. I have already posted on YouTube, I do believe, but definitely on Instagram, little snippets of my magical kitchen. So stay tuned for more, you guys. Today's video, we're going to get into the ephemera. So I'm going to go and share with you some of these beautiful things that I found. So this first thing that I found is a book. Excuse me. Let's go get your favorite cuppa too, by the way. I'm having a cup of coffee, but of course, it's always best to have your favorite cuppa with you when we're hanging out together. So this is a book that I found in going through some of the belongings here that my mill had. And this is actually something that touched my soul because I gave this to her a long time ago. I think I gave this to her back in the early 2000s. So yeah, it's quite old. And this says, "With love from my kitchen, a collection of recipes, hints, secrets, and heirloom treasures of good eating." You're supposed to put your name right here. And this is like a journal. It's a recipe journal. She never used it. She must have put it away somewhere and didn't realize that she had put it away. So I'm going to show you as we get into this, I found so many of her recipes. So I will be able to transfer her recipes. And you know, those of you that have been with me, I love to write. I love to journal. I love to feel specific, fabulous pens in my hand. I love so many different types of styles of pens, but there are several in particular that I've shared with you that I really love. In particularly, my pen that I keep in my documents binder, as well as my pen that I keep in my handbag, and that is my diamond-topped pen that I actually just purchased at the Dollar Tree, and I love it. It feels so good in my hand, and the beauty about that pen is that it's refillable, so I can get a new pen insert to continue to be able to use it. So I will be writing in here, and it's just, it has all these little tabs. And it's so fabulous. And let me see if I can find a website to see if it's still available. It says Strawberry Patch, Atlanta, Georgia. Copyright 1989 by Nancy Radcliffe Edwards. Okay. So I'm going to read this to you. There is no website because back then the internet wasn't necessarily a big thing. So I'm going to say this out loud and you can pause the video to write it down and see if you can pen a note to this particular place and see if they still have this. It's called Strawberry Patch, P.O. Box 52404, Atlanta, Georgia 30355-0404. It tells you how to use the book, and there's alphabetical tabs in here. So, for example, appendix, beverages and pantry foods. B is breads, preserves, jellies, and pickles. C is salads. That's weird. Salad, salad dressing, soups and sandwiches. Okay, so no, I guess it doesn't necessarily go with the letter, but it's just, those are the tabs. So you have A, B, C, D. It goes all the way to L. Yeah, I don't know why they did that. That seems a little odd. But there's also lovely designs on the pages. And they are tabbed by this beautiful pink color tab. On each tab, there's a design at the top. And it says recipe, and then you write the recipe, and then the page that your recipe is going to be on. So, for example, you would put a recipe here, okay? And then you'd write on the bottom the page number, and then you could go back to the tab and write in the recipe and the page number so that whomever was looking at the book could reference the book and find that recipe. So this is a beautiful legacy that you could, and each tab is different with its imagery. This is a beautiful book that you could leave as a legacy for your family, along with recipe cards and a recipe box. I have so much to do. You guys, this sounds so corny, but I love life. And I just put a post on Facebook recently, which by the time you see this video is going to be towards the end of May. Today is April 25th, the day that I'm filming it. And if you go to my blog, The Enchanting World of Miladyleela.blogspot.com, which you can also find by clicking my link feather, Miladyleela.com, and it'll take you to a link to get directly to the blog. I posted a quote of the day, Thought to Ponder, and it was all about making your own magic. And my magic, one of the things that is magical to me is that I just love life so much. I am never bored because there's always so much to do. I make my own magic. And I can make magic today or moving forward by taking a pen in my hand and journaling these beautiful recipes that my mother-in-law had written, my mom had written, I have written into either a book like this or in a recipe box. I have slips of paper they're all, you know, put together in a notebook, for example, but they're all loose leaf pages that are not bound in a book. I can make magic by putting all those things together. And there's something said about that. It brings such joy to be able to find something that makes you happy, that is a pleasantry for you. So writing recipes might not be your thing, but you get what I'm saying. So moving on. I also found this cute little journal that I had also gifted to my mill, and she never used it. She never used it, but she did write inside the date, which was 2007, and she wrote, Tina Miller from daughter Dena. My mill considered me her daughter. I was not her daughter-in-law. And truthfully speaking, she was mom to me as well. She was just beautiful and wonderful, and I miss her so much. But these pages are gorgeous and beautiful indeed. They're all toile pages inside, and they're all the same. But they're so lovely, and the book is bound in like a cardstock. So I love this. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to write in here, or if I'm going to art journal in here, but I think this book is lovely and I am honored to have found it and have it back in my possession. Yes, it would have been lovely for her to journal in and keep her journal, but it's so wonderful that I have it now. It's almost like, you know, the circle of life. Life is full circle. Another thing that I found of hers was this cute little hand mirror. This is not necessarily ephemera, but I thought it was really sweet. Just a little mirror. And there you can see, there I am. I love this. And I just think this is so cute. I'm probably going to do some sort of DIY project on the back of this mirror and put some gems or some bling. I don't know, something cute and fancy and very girly on it. I haven't decided yet, but I just think this little hand mirror is so sweet and I love it. And I'll probably add it to my collection of mirrors on my vanity. I have currently right now, and you'll see when I do a room tour, I have a beautiful three-paneled mirror that was my mother-in-law's here at the cottage. And it was in the living room, and it is now in my vanity, my vanity wardrobe room on my vanity. I also have my makeup mirror, which is lighted so I can adjust the lights, and I have a hand mirror, and then I also have a little trinket dish that has a tiny round mirror, which is mainly for decorations. But I have quite a collection of hand mirrors. I have a beautiful silver one, which I got from the Dollar Tree. And I'm not going to share that right now because you'll see it in a vanity tour video or a wardrobe room tour. But I also have a few others that I keep for whenever I do my Miladyleela trunk shows and I share my handmade jewelry. But now I can add this to the mix. And I just think it's so sweet, really, really cute. And I might be able to add that to my suitcase whenever I travel to do my shows. So that's really beautiful. I also found Do It Together Better Cookies. This is a vintage cookbook by Pillsbury on how to, recipes, in fact. And here's a cute little recipe on how to create a sailing ship. So beautiful. And this is really showing you how you can do it with, to make it edible. Let's see. Yeah. To make it edible by using a molding mixture, which is 2 cups of salt, 1 cup of Pillsbury best flour, and powdered alum. So it wouldn't necessarily be edible, but it makes it like a modeling mixture, almost like a Play-Doh type of substance, so that you can create and do different shapes like this. And as you can see, it's like holding cookies. So that's a cute idea. I love that. It also shows you how to make a Christmas tree, a manger scene, And there's all sorts of ideas in here. And the other cool thing about it is that there are ads in here. So there's a Miro cookie cutter and decorator set for $2.25. So you know that this is very, very vintage. I'm trying to see if there is a date in here. No, I don't see a date. How to make an old world castle. It even shows you designs on that. So lovely. So that's really exciting. Then I found this old ad inside one of her books for free strawberries. Get free strawberries up to a 65-cent value when you buy Cool Whip and Jell-O pudding. And there's a coupon in here that expires in August of 1986. So this is definitely journal worthy, putting this little tidbit into a journal in a tuck-in. I love that. Win a cottage from Cottage Fries. Cottage Fries sweepstakes. Official rules. No purchase necessary. And this coupon for Cottage Fries potato chips also expired in August of 1986. So this is definitely one that you would not want to glue into your pages of a journal. You would want to fold it up as is and put that inside as a tuck-in. These are mainly cooking kind of things that I found. This is the Jell-O pudding sampler. I love this. And now that my wardrobe is all designed, I can sit here on my cute and adorable little love seat, snuggle in with my favorite cuppa, and go through these books and just unwind and chill and just really be creative and inspired. I just love it so much. Not only is my wardrobe, for those of you that have not been following me for a while, you wouldn't know, but not only is my wardrobe my dressing room, as thus the name wardrobe, I've also created my wardrobe, a section of it, as my art studio, and I cannot wait to share it with you. I've actually taken the closet that was the closet of this room. This used to be a bedroom. And I've created the closet of my wardrobe as my art studio. It's very tiny and very magical indeed, and it's just amazing. I cannot wait to share it with you guys. Oh my gosh, I have so much to share. So yes, I'm very excited. And if you watched my previous video to this one, I was talking about vintage linens, and I did not have as much energy as I have right now because I, at that time, and you'll probably see this video like a week later, so I will go ahead and link the previous video. I did not have energy. Oh my gosh. I needed to eat. I had hardly eaten anything and I was feeling like really shaky. So I have much more energy now because I had a breakfast bar as a little snack and I feel so much better. This is 21 new ways to serve hamburger. I just love these. These are just so fun. And this is how to have the most with cake mix. So this is fabulous, you guys. This is like the old school way of decorating cakes that I absolutely freaking love. So much better than today's ways. There's something about the vintage era that is just so magical. Just the way they iced cakes and everything. It's just like, look at this beautiful pink cake. Is that not to die for? Oh my gosh. It's so beautiful. So beautiful. And these pictures, they do not make pictures like this anymore. It was almost like, and I don't even know if it was a filter back then. I think it was just the way the camera took the picture, but it was just so special. Today, we mimic the filters of these designs. And even the little toppers that they would put on the cakes, just so, so cute. So cute. I love it. Let's see if I can find a date on this one. No. Here they made a little carousel. So precious. Okay, moving on. This is Diet for a Healthy Heart by the makers of Fleischmann's Margarine, which I know that some of you might be eating margarine still, but I don't like margarine. It is plastic. No. Do some research on margarine, you guys, if you're eating it. And I guarantee you probably won't want to eat it ever again. I eat butter when I have butter. And I don't do a lot of butter. I mean, I really watch what I eat. But, you know, because butter can be, it's not necessarily heart healthy. But honestly, back when this cookbook was designed, I'm sure they didn't know how bad margarine was for you. Let me just say this. If there was an apocalypse and you had a tub of margarine in your fridge, the tub of margarine would still be alive millions of years from now. Yeah. So anyhow, this book is very cool, and it has some really unique pictures as well, old school type of pictures. Even though it is about margarine, you can substitute, and I will, with butter, these recipes. And I love all this little artwork, you know, and you can go through and pick some recipes out. And I realize that these books are probably not available, but I encourage you to go to your favorite thrift shop and search the book section. You never know what you're going to find. It's like coming home with treasures whenever you go to a thrift store anyways. And one of my favorite things to do as of late, because, you know, I've really downsized, and honestly, you guys, I really don't even need more books, but I'm a bibliophile. I love books. I cannot get enough. And so you never know what you're going to find, and you can spend the day just browsing. And you know what? They don't even mind if you take your phone. Sometimes I shouldn't say this. Shh. But if you see a recipe that you like in one of those vintage books, take your phone, snap a picture of it, and you know, you have the recipe if you're not one that likes to have a lot of stuff in your home. But as you can see, and when I do the home tour, you will see how much I am able to fit into a tiny little cottage. But we do have three bedrooms, guys. It's, you know, it's not exactly that tiny. My daughter moved out of a two-bedroom home that had no basement, and she has two dogs and a cat and a baby and her husband. And, you know, like our home here at the Storybook Cottage is bigger than what she came from, but it's still small. And now that she lives in our castle, she really has room to grow, and it's wonderful for her. But getting back to this video. Yes, okay, so this is fish Creole. That doesn't sound real appetizing to me, but I love the idea of Creole. It's very, you know, New Orleans. It just, that would be yummy. I love the flavor. And I guess depending on the fish, it might be good. There's pizza party and Mediterranean vegetables, crunchy breadsticks, challah bread recipe. That sounds really good. That looks beautiful too. I love how it's twisted. Sweet and sour fish. Yuck, that doesn't sound good. To me anyways. Then there's chicken pate, stuffed cabbage. So all sorts of yummy recipes. Okay. And this one is They Taste So Good Recipes, Ideas, and Hints. Look at the vintage information. It's just so cute. I love it. I cannot get enough of it. I have so many booklets. These are like little booklets to go through. This has recipes for salads, main courses, Italian foods. Look at this, you guys. The pictures are gorgeous. They do not make cookbooks like this today. Granted, the cookbooks today are fabulous as well, and I own many. One of these days, I should probably do a cookbook collection and share with you my cookbooks. That would be fun. Let me know in the comments below if you would be interested in that. And if you are, and I get enough response, then perhaps I will do a video on that. But in the meantime, I love the imagery in newer cookbooks, but they just don't make them like they used to. It's just so cute. Oh, and here's another ad. This is for Karo syrup, peanut butter and Karo peanut butter crisp treats. These look good. I should probably make these. I love peanut butter. Oriental foods. Oh, and by the way, you guys, if you have a Sam's Club membership, and or probably Costco has the same thing, but we're Sam Club members. Jimmy and I purchased just recently a box of General Tso's chicken. And we also purchased the orange chicken, which I haven't tried yet, but I'm sure it's delicious. And we purchased the pork egg rolls. So tried the pork egg rolls. They are fabulous. So fabulous. They're really crispy and yummy. But this one night I made a recipe. It was really just following the recipe on the box for the General Tso's chicken. So if you love oriental foods, this is like the next best thing to going to a Chinese restaurant. It was so good. I dragged out my rice maker that I haven't used in years. Since Jimmy bought it for me, I never used it. And mainly because we were very busy taking care of my mill here at the cottage. And we really didn't have room to bring a lot of our stuff on top of her stuff when we were living here with her. We mainly lived here around all of her things. So I never brought my rice cooker up, and Jimmy had gifted it to me for one year for my birthday, I do believe, or for Christmas. I don't know. And so I just recently used it for the first time, and I love it. It makes the perfect rice. I'm not really good. I'm great at cooking. I'm a really good cook and a good baker. Actually a great baker for certain things. I'm not the greatest at cookies though. I have yet to get that mastered. However, the rice cooker is perfect because I don't do rice very well in other ways of making it. So the rice cooker was perfect. I made rice. Then once it was chilled, I chilled the rice. I made fried rice using simply a bag of frozen mixed vegetables in my wok with the rice. And I did a scrambled egg first, scrambled that up, put the ingredients together and made fried rice. If you follow me on Patreon, you might find my recipe for fried rice on Patreon at some point. But in the meantime, I then cooked up the General Tso's, and it comes with two packages of the sauce, but I found that you only need to use one package. So you can put the other package aside for some other meal and make it spicy like the seasoning that General Tso's has. So mix that all up and follow the directions other than the fact that I only used one package of the seasoning sauce and served it on top of rice. It was amazing. Amazing. So I highly encourage you to go to your local Sam's Club. If you're a member, I know they have it there, and pick up their General Tso's chicken in their freezer section. And you can look for it at Costco as well. I guarantee if you like Chinese food, you will love it. This is also the Dormeyer Electric Mix Treasures. This is interesting. How to get the best results from your Dormeyer Power Chef electric food mixer. Oh, okay. So this is the mixer that my mother-in-law must have had at one point in her life. And I wonder if it was the stainless steel, because the picture in here does not look like the one that she had. But she had this fabulous stainless steel mixer. And I can't remember if it was Dormeyer or not, but it might be. And this might have been the cookbook that came with it. And you don't necessarily need to have that mixer to create all of these wonderful ideas in here. So there's angel food cake, feather white cake, frosty lemon cake. That sounds fabulous to me. Comfort icing, fudge frosting, old time boiled icing, 5-minute icing, et cetera, et cetera. So there's, excuse me, something just fell. So yes, there's all kinds of lovelies in here. And this was just a page that fell out that has to do with a Pattern Club member. And my mother-in-law joined this place too, I know, because she used to get all of these books. So fun. They're crochet pattern books. So, and I did actually come across some of those as well. This is mainly like a cookbook vintage ephemera video. The pattern books I had already donated to Goodwill because I don't really crochet like that. So I gave those away to somebody that would really benefit and enjoy them. So then she also has little snippets of newspaper clippings of recipes that she liked. So that is very cute. Then this is a fancy cookie and appetizers and pastry recipe book. And you can tell how old this one is, you guys. It's like just crazy. Oh my gosh. I'm super excited about this. So many recipes in here. So like, for example, cookie decorating, decorator directions. It tells you what tips to use in decorating with cakes, cheese appetizers. I can't even talk. Party time and pastry time. Torts, cream puffs. Oh my gosh. I'm definitely going to be doing the cream puffs recipe. That looks fabulous. Let me just go over this with you. Half a cup of butter or margarine. Let's use the butter, right? We just talked about margarine. A cup of water, a cup of sifted all-purpose flour, a quarter teaspoon of salt, 4 eggs, 2 cups of whipping cream, whipped and sweetened. And here is the recipe. So you can go ahead and pause this video so that you can get this recipe for these magical cream puffs. Okay, and then I found Pillsbury's Creative Cooking in Minutes, especially good and easy meals for all occasions. I love this style of cookbooks. I have several of my own that I thrifted, and one of them in particular, I think I might have done a flip through of. By the way, I have a playlist of magazine and book flip throughs. So I may just be inclined to do a flip through of this book at some point in time. But in the meantime, you can go and see what I have on the playlist. I will go ahead and link that below either in a card or in an end screen for you so you can check out that playlist. But I just love the vintage pictures inside. Like I said, they don't make cookbooks imagery the same way today. They don't. It's just so, so fabulous. Oh, and then she has a snippet here, frozen fruit treat. That looks interesting. Here's another little recipe that you might be interested in. I don't know that I would particularly like this one. It has crushed pineapple drained. I don't know, maybe. I don't know. We'll see. If you guys try it, let me know what you think. Green bean casserole, fondue. Let's see what else. Just like here's a whole meal. It shows you like the main dish, bread, a salad, and a side. It's just so fun. I cannot wait to get through these and just like browse. Okay, so then I'm not going to go through all of this because I haven't really had the opportunity yet to do so, but I did find this piece of ephemera that my mother-in-law, she loved to write in her journals and notebooks, and she wrote cookbook and patterns. So not only did she put her creative cookery ideas in here, she also put some patterns in here of hers. So I'm very honored to have this. And, you know, the book is semi-falling apart, so I'm probably going to rebind it somehow. and figure out a way to do that. But I just love having these things. It's just so, so nice that I found these items, and they're just wonderful memories. And then there's this. This is like an old-fashioned folio that opened up in thirds. So that's pretty cool. Everything's flying out. And in here, I found all kinds of ephemera. And some of these things that she wrote are probably only understandable by her, but that's okay. You know, they're just wonderful little snippets to have and to keep from her. And then there is this little notebook, and there's a bunch of recipes in here. It's just amazing. And one of the recipes I found that my family completely loves is her recipe for snickerdoodles. And this is not, it's actually not snickerdoodles. Snickerdoodles would be the cookie. This is a recipe that is almost like an ambrosia salad. And it's made with Cool Whip. And my daughter, Nicole, absolutely loved this recipe. So this is one recipe that is definitely a family recipe that I will be pasting inside the book that I shared with you earlier, which is this one. Rather than rewrite it, it's on this little snippet of paper. I could just go ahead and paste it because there's nothing on the back. So that would be okay since it's just a snippet and not inside something else with information on the back. And I cannot wait to do that. I'm just super excited about all of these things. So many recipes. And then more patterns and ideas of things that she made her own magic with. And that is something that she was a master of, making her own magic. My father-in-law had passed away many years prior to her passing, and she always found a way to keep herself busy and just entertain herself and move on with life. And that right there is just beautiful in that she didn't even realize. I'm trying not to cry, you guys. Try not to cry. Yeah. She didn't even realize the legacy by finding all these things that she left about teaching people silently to make their own magic. She was such a lovely lady, and she is on one of my videos. I will try to find that one too. If I can find it, I will link it for you. She and I went thrift shopping. We went to lunch and went thrift shopping, and it was so much fun. And I dedicated the video to her. So I'll see if I can find it and link it below. But in this folio, there's actually a lot of paper left too, that, which this is really cool. There is like, let me try to hold this up to show you. There's like this much paper that she didn't write on that I could use in journaling, for vintage papers. I mean, this notebook has got to be, my goodness, she probably had this from the 70s because this is definitely a 70s pattern. And then on the other side, so it's really cool because there's two pockets on each side when you open it up. So that is just like super, super cool. Then there was an envelope in here. And in this envelope, there's more recipes. So I have my work cut out for me, and it's okay because this is how I make my magic. as I said, I love to write. I love to come up with ideas and keep myself busy and journal. I love to cook. I really enjoy being domestic and creating sacred space within my home. And so these things, that these treasured pieces of ephemera, are things that I will be able to go through and totally enjoy. Yes. And then one last thing, I found this book. This is Marilyn, A Life in Pictures. And this is like a coffee table book, and I will be leaving this book in my studio. It's just something very inspirational to look through. Old world Hollywood. Just really, really beautiful. I haven't really had an opportunity to read this book yet either. But I just love pictures. And perhaps I'll do a flip through on this one too. Leave me a comment below if you would like to see a flip through of this. So anyhow, with that being said, I hope that you enjoyed this video. And hi, Jimmy.
What was that?
I don't know. I heard something too. I thought maybe you got into something. He just came in to tell me he heard something, and I don't know what it was. Oh, well, back to the video. Thank you for being here. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I appreciate your time. And if you haven't subscribed, I know I invited you earlier in the video, but please do, and hit the little bell as well so that you don't miss a single video when I post. And check out my links below. I will have all of the links of so that you can find where I am on the net by going to the link feather, miladyleela.com. It takes you, you click on that, and then it has links on the feather to tell you wherever I am. So I hope that you will continue to follow me everywhere I am on the net. That would make me so happy. And I hope that I've inspired you to make your own magic and go through maybe some of your old vintage treasures and evoke some of those memories from the past that help you to move forward into the future with love and creativity. With all of that being said, thank you for being here. I love you all so very much. I wish you so many blessings, so much love, and many friendships to come. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.